بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم. أما بعد، continue with the hadith. تعرض الفتن على القلوب. We can figuratively translate it as satanic media through television screens, plasma screens, cell phones, computers, etc. via the internet, social media, will bombard your heart directly in front of you. فأي قلب أشربها نكتت فيه نكتة سوداء. The rewrite is saying, any heart that is ready to be impregnated with this concept, any heart that entertains this intoxication, any heart that welcomes this. Ulama explain, if you look at the dictionary, ushriba means to permeate, to dominate, to become infused. So any heart that entertains all these avenues, then those avenues will become infused in their heart. Mufassirin explain, Imam Qurtubi, وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلِ. The Bani Israel, when they worship the cow, they allowed their hearts to drink, meaning to become consumed, to be overtaken, a حُبُّ الْعِجْلِ, that eventually they loved that action. So any heart that allows this to happen, they will start loving it, and thronging it, and thriving for it. Imam Qurtubi mentions also, شُرْب دُونَ الْأَكْلِ, because they've mentioned water and not food, because water reaches all places, it permeates. No matter where water is, it goes through, it makes a way to get into it. And the movement of water is fast. Like this, if you allow these forms of batil to permeate you, what will happen? نُكِتَتْ فِي نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدَى, a black spot, darkness will start enveloping this heart. وَأَيُّ قَلْبٍ أَنْكَرَهَا نُكِتَتْ فِيهِ نُكْتَةٌ بَيْضَاءُ. And whoever stays far away from it, abandons it, keeps his distance from these means, then a white spot is placed on his heart. حَتَّى تَصِيرَ عَلَى قَلْبَيْنِ. There are two types of person that will come out of this. One is where his heart is white, عَلَىٰ أَبْيَضْ مِثْلِ الصَّفَىٰ, like a white stone. Ulama have explained, what is Safa? هُوَ الْحَجَرُ الْلَامِسْ, هُوَ الْحَجَرُ الْأَمْلَسْ الَّذِي لَا يَعْلَكُ بِهِ الشَّيْءِ. It is that stone that's very slippery, or it's smooth, so nothing bonds onto it. So like how a stone that is very smooth, dirt cannot stick onto it, likewise the hearts that abandon this type of fitna, فَلَا تَذُرُّهُ فِتْنَةٌ مَا دَامَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ. No fitna, whether it's the present fitna or possibly the fitnas of Dajjal, will not infect this person's heart. وَالْآخَرُ, the second category, أَسْوَدُ مُرْبَادًا كَالْكُوزِ مُجَخِّيًا. And the other one is like the same container stone, but now it is enveloped, it is covered, it is overwhelmed by blackness, you cannot see any whiteness in it. Like an inverted cup, and the quality of this inverted cup is la ya'rifu ma'rufan. This person is so much in darkness, they cannot identify what's good for them. So when you speak to them and you tell them this is wrong, this is harmful, this will destroy your life, doesn't make sense to them. وَلَا يُنْكِرُ مُنْكَرًا. And whatever is evil, they cannot differentiate. So whether a person is grabbing a flame of fire and is destroying himself, or is putting his hand in the mouth of a serpent, he cannot distinguish it. Mujakhi and ulama explain an inverted cup, there's two qualities. One is, when a cup is inverted, you cannot put anything inside it. Likewise, these people's hearts are sealed, sealed from hidayat. Second is, that cup that is filled with the nur of Allah, the nur of Iman. When you invert it, all the water that's inside, the nur, will be lost. Now that heart will be void of Iman and probably, possibly at risk of losing the Iman. إِلَّا مَا أُشْرِبَ مِنْ هَوَاهُ. Except a person who now his ambition, his desire, his focus is only his passion and his fancies, and that what he's living for, his life is only this year. So if we look at it today, through these avenues, it is like an injection from shaitan. Four avenues will govern the heart: what we see, what we hear, what we speak, and what we think. When a person is glued to these screens, then his eye is glued, his ears are glued, his mind is glued, and his tongue also, whether it's music, whether it's the words, whether it's these idols. And why is taswir haram in Islam? Why don't angels come in a house where there is a taswir? Because this is how shaitan took people to shirk. It is a beginning of shirk. So the farishtas stay far even from a house that doesn't have shirk, but a house that has pictures. The farishtas say, we will boycott these houses as well. And the coming of Dajjal is the great idol that's going to come. So initially you have to put the small idols in the heart before you inject them with the big idols. Batil, through this, wants to control your mind. Slowly, slowly, when the mind is in control, then your heart is in control. Secondly, the result is to strip a person of their haya. Imagine a person that is watching pornography. He is seeing people committing zina, where Allah's azab, stones, rocks, boulders from the sky should fall on that locality. People are committing incest, people are committing sodomy. This viewer is taking pleasure on ma'asiyat, on the disobedience of Allah. He's enjoying it. When Nabi alayhi salam said that when you pass the places of evil and sin, then run away from those places. Where Allah's azab came, run away from that places. Be crying and in tears when you see Allah's azab come to any town or locality. You should be running away from that, crying. In those times, there was one Fir'aun, there was one Qarun. Money is my God, I am God, my power is God. Inna arsalna ad thamud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, all these people who declared that they were gods and they had power, inna arsalna alayhim sayha, inna arsalna alayhim hasiba, inna arsalna alayhim rihan sarsaran. In those times, there was one God, one fitna in one area, and Allah's azab came. Can we imagine in today's time, there's thousands of Fir'auns, thousands of Hamans, thousands of Ad and Thamud, thousands of Qawm Lut, and not only in one place, but combined places on earth. Can we imagine what azab should have come to the Ummah? Mawlana Yusuf used to say, it is only the dua of Janabi Rasulullah when ijtimai azab, a colossal azab will come from the heavens, which will wipe out my entire ummah. He said, it is the dua of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that is blocking this azab to descend on the ummah. So to remove this haya and modesty, where we never ever thought of Muslim swingers group, Muslim groups that are promoting homosexuality and lesbianism, could have never been fathomed and pondered. These have become common in one area. Couples get together and exchange keys and they go to their houses. One lady said, I got married 6 months later. My husband told me we're going for an occasion. We arrived at a nice house. I recognized the people there. There were many young people, elderly people from my neighborhood. We enjoyed the meals. And after the meals, slowly, a music in the background was played. Then various couples started dancing and strolling around. And I noticed that some men would latch on other men's wives. And the husband now would take the other person's wife. She said, I thought so, I was hallucinating. Is it possible that couples are doing this? I was feeling very uneasy. My husband came to me and said, why don't you speak to my friend? And why don't you go with a stroll with him? And later on we will meet up. And I noticed people going to different rooms. I was stunned and baffled. And this reality came on me like a ton of bricks. My husband became upset with me. He shoved me and pushed me in the direction of his friend. This was too much for me. I ran to the car. My husband came to the car and drove me home. He was very, very upset with me, locked me in the house for 3 days, abused me, assaulted me, told me how I had shamed him in front of his friends. She said, I pretended that I would agree and next time I would go and comply. The day he opened the door, I never went back again to this beast. This is the condition of the Muslim Ummah and the situations that are out there. So this will create behayai and immodesty. Let us just look at television and the statistics that are out there are just statistics which we know about. Otherwise, more than that, Allahu A'lam. Every child 2 to 5 years old watches TV 32 hours a week. 6 to 11 years old, 28 hours. 2/3 of households watch TV during meals. 53% of households. They have no rules about television. Kids are busy on it all the time. 51% of households, the TV is on most of the time. Advertisers target our small, innocent children. A child, a small youngster sees an average of 2,000 beer and wine ads in an average year. Kids see their favorite characters smoking, drinking, involved in sexual situations and risky behaviors, and that is as if it is legitimizing that. An average American child will see 200,000 violent acts, 16,000 murders by the age of 18. 2/3 of all programming contains violence. Programs designed for children more often contain violence than adult TV. Most violent acts go unpunished on TV, which are accompanied by humor, like we see the cartoons, etc. Many shows glamorize violence. They show it like a glamour. The number of sex scenes on TV has nearly doubled since 1998, with 70% of the top 20 most watched shows by teens include this. This is normal TV. We're looking at YouTube and other avenues. The numbers are unlimited. Just the number of videos watched per day on YouTube is 5 billion. There are 31 million YouTube channels. According to the American survey, the average American watches 4 hours of TV a day. In a 65-year life, that person would have spent 9 years of their life in front of the TV. Can we imagine what propaganda and what mind control? Just for family life, the percentage of households that possess at least one TV is 99. Other houses call 99%, 2.2 TVs per household. Many, 66%, have more than 3 TV sets. The number of hours per TV on average home is 6 hours 47 minutes. They're watching television every day. Number of hours annually in Americans, 250 billion. The value of time assumed on an average watch, $5 per hour, is $1.25 trillion. The average Americans that pay for TV is 56%. Now the status and data has increased. The percentage of Americans who say they watch TV too much are 49%. With regards to children, approximate number of effects on children, 4,000 per week minutes are involved in television. The number of minutes per week that an average child watches television is 1,680. Percentage of parents would like to limit their children watching TV is 73%, but they don't do that. The percentage of 4 years to 6 years, 6 years is, the numbers are staggering. The average American youth spends 900 hours in school, but 1,500 hours watching television. By the time in every child finishes elementary school, 8,000 number of violent acts have been seen, and by the age of 18, 200,000. The percentage of Americans who believe TV violence helps in real life mayhem, people still believe that it's going to help you in a situation because you know how to handle a situation. The number of 30-second TV commercials seen in a year by an average child is 20,000. Number of TV commercials seen by an average person by the age of 65 is 2 million. The amount of spending on TV advertisements has jumped from 15 billion to a staggered number as we speak. Forget that, immodesty. The youngest known child to have given birth was 5 years, 7 months. Every year, an estimated 1 million girls aged from 15 to 19 years get pregnant. 12 million of them give birth. 777,000 births occur to adolescent girls younger than 15 years. 3 in 10 teen American girls will get pregnant at least once before the age of 20. The amount and studies, these figures, forget that. The immodesty means people are no more getting married anymore. With fewer teens entering into marriage, the proportion of births to unmarried teens has increased dramatically, 29% in 1970 to 89% in 2014. People are not getting married anymore. According to a survey, adults aged 20 to 59, women have an average of 4 sex partners during their lifetime, while men have 7. Bay Hayai has come on. Studies have revealed that children lose their virginity at a very young age. Experts say that with average age of puberty going down from 9 to 10 years for girls, 10 to 11 years from boys, means at the age of 9 to 11, people are losing their modesty and their shame. And worse than that is the pornography industry, which is enormous. It's a $17 billion industry. 25% of search engine requests are related to this. 40 million Americans say they regularly visited porn sites. 70% of men 18 to 24 visit a porn site at least once a month. The average age of first exposure to pornography is 11. That's average age, means from a child of 6, 7, 8 and 9 are exposed to this. And this will impact their life later on. 84% of people between 18 and 49 have watched pornography films. Every second, 28,000 users are watching porn. $3,000 are spent on pornography on the internet. Every second, 272 people are typing the word adult on a search. And every second, 1 in 5 mobile sites searches every second are pornography. 37 pornographic videos are created in the US every day. 2.5 billion emails containing porn are sent every day. 68 million search queries related to pornography. 116,000 queries. About 200,000 Americans are classified as porn addicts. 40 million Americans regularly visit porn sites. 35% of internet downloads are related to pornography. 34% of internet users experience unwanted exposure. According to a survey, 47% of families state that they have a pornographic problem in their family. And it has increased infidelity to 300%. 40% of people identified as addicts lose their spouses. 58% suffer financial losses. 33% lose their jobs. 68% of divorce cases. 1 in 5 youth pastors. 1 in 7 senior pastors. That's 50,000 U.S. church leaders are hooked on pornography. The statistics, we can study it, are innumerable. The numbers are staggered. Let us make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn to Allah. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the reality and protect us from all this fitness. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.